103.7 Q Country. Brian back in the office with you for another Monday. Thanks so much for having us on. We'll get through it together. Can you believe in one of his first meetings in Nashville, Luke Combs was told that the songs he shared that day weren't good enough? They all went number one, he said on Twitter last week. Even though I'm leaving is one of them. 103.7 Q Country. Daddy, I'm afraid. Today's Country 103.7 Q Country. After all the rain this weekend, we finally have a dry day today. Although it is mostly cloudy, but I'll take it. Not too cold either. Highs in the lower 40s. Jason Aldean, we back. 103.7 Q Country. Where's a gonna stay? Lee Bryce on Q Country. And good Monday morning to you. I'm Brian. Thanks for having us on today. Coming up, not this weekend, but next weekend. Saturday, January 25th. Lowcast are going to be performing down at Touch of Texas in Binghamton. The general admission advance sale tickets are $25. And if you wait till the week of the show, that's next week, they're $32. But if you don't want to pay that much money, keep listening to Q Country all this week because we have tickets for you to win both in the morning with Chris Allinger and in the afternoon with JB. Keep listening all week long for your chance to go see Lowcast, Touch of Texas in Binghamton, Saturday, January 25th. Going to be a great show. Hope to see you there with 103.7 Q Country. Garth Brooks and Blake Shelton, Dive Bar, is on Q Country right now.
We'll turn that bottle up and... I got a cop
car. Today's Country 103.7 Q Country. These guys, Old Dominion, going to be one of the special guests on Kenny Chesney's Chillactivication Tour this summer. He's bringing that to Syracuse, St. Joseph's Health Amphitheater at Lakeview, August 20th. One Man Band is on Q Country. Been flying solo. Leaving a voicemail is now considered rude? I'll tell you about it after Ever Church and Monsters. It's new to Q. I killed my first. That's new to Q from Ever Church, Monsters on 103.7 Q Country, Monday morning. Thanks for having us on at the office today. I'm Brian. So there's a new book called Kill Reply All, A Modern Guide to Online Etiquette. And the book says leaving a voicemail is now considered rude. You should just hang up and text the person instead. I don't know how I feel about this. I leave voicemails all the time. Not everyone will respond to a text message because it doesn't seem quite as urgent. But if you leave a voicemail and someone's calling you, yeah, it seems more urgent than if they're just texting you. What do you think? Let us know on Twitter and Facebook. We're at 103.7 Q Country, and I'm at WX Brian D. Matt Stell is next to 103.7 Q Country. Hang on. Cody Allen. 103.7 Q Country. Jimmy Allen announced he's going to be releasing new music early this year with a very unlikely pop star. He's going to be teaming up with Noah Cyrus. That's Miley Cyrus's little sister. Can't wait to hear this duet when it comes out. Jimmy Allen now, Make Me Want To, Q Country. Long way and nothing that I don't. Some big news about Justin Bieber was released last week. He confirmed he's been diagnosed with Lyme disease. So hopefully he can recover from that quickly. Dan and Shay, Justin Bieber, 10,000 Hours on Q Country. Tim McGraw, 103.7 Q Country. Brian, Monday morning. Already counting down to the weekend because we're all tired. It's Monday. So why not, right? Well, your weekend going to get a whole lot more fun if you listen to Q Country Saturday night. Red Cup Country is your Saturday night soundtrack for whatever you have planned. All party theme music from all your favorite artists, along with requests, mini mixes, and you can even download the Red Cup Country app. Tune in from 7 to midnight this and every Saturday night and let the party begin. Red Cup Country from the station that loves a good party, 103.7 Q Country. We know you. Today's Country 103.7 Q Country. It's Brian with Ingrid Andress now. More Hearts Than Mine on 103.7 Q Country. I can't wait to. 103.7 Q Country. We still don't know for sure what Sam Hunt's tour plans are for 2020, but he has announced another outdoor one-off show. He's going to be performing at the NHL Stadium Series game on February 15th. That's going to be broadcast on NBC with the Colorado Avalanche and Los Angeles Kings from Colorado Springs. Ken Folks on Q Country. I saw you going by me like I loved you. Today's Country 103.7 Q Country. Do you make a six-figure salary? Yeah, I don't. Maybe you don't either. A lot of us probably don't, but There's a new job that maybe you want to apply for. It pays a six-figure salary. After Scotty McCreary. In between, it's New to Q. I'm a little bit. New to Q, Scotty McCreary, in between on 103.7 Q Country as we get ready to head out to lunch next. But first, yeah, there's a company that's testing out new higher salaries to try to attract better managers for their stores. Perfect for lunchtime. It's Taco Bell. Yes, Taco Bell says they're going to offer $100,000 salaries to managers. That's up from the normal range Taco Bell pays their managers, which is $50,000 to $80,000 per year. So if you're looking to make a lot of money, maybe $100,000 a year, try to become a manager at your local Taco Bell. We have one right here in Ithaca. Maybe you're heading there for lunch next. We'll take you out to lunch next with Chris Young on 103.7 Q Country.
It's Chris.
Made it to lunchtime, halfway through the workday already. Monday flying by. It's 103.7 Q Country. I'm Brian. We have all your favorites coming up too while you eat lunch. Brad Paisley, Kerry Underwood, and Jake Owen all coming up in the next 10 minutes. Right now, Thomas Rhett, Remember You Young, 103.7 Q Country. Hey, bud. Jake Owen heading out on tour with Lady Antebellum this year on their Ocean 2020 tour that stops in Syracuse in September. All right, Kelsey Ballerini, Homecoming Queen on Q Country. Hey, homecoming. Got a lot of mud on my tires over the weekend with all that rain. Glad it's finally dry today. 103.7 Q Country, I'm Brian. Hope you're enjoying your lunch. And if you want to see what's going on this week as you eat, make sure you visit FingerLakesTop10.com. It's powered by the 16 dog-friendly wineries along the Cayuga Lake Wine Trail, inviting you to taste a bit of history. FingerLakesTop10.com. Plan your week with 103.7 Q Country.
Always be.
Today's Country 103.7 Q Country, and the romance is very much still alive between Kane Brown and his wife Caitlin. He shared a post on Instagram last week of he and his wife out on the town, and he said Caitlin is his best freaking friend. Quote. Kane Brown, Homesick on Q Country. Dancing in the. How about Dustin Lynch, Riding Roads on Q Country. How long will you wait on hold when calling a business? I'll tell you the average and what type of hold music we hate the least. Coming up after Carly Pearce and Lee Bryce. I hope you're happy now. It's New to Q. It's all New to Q from Carly Pearce and Lee Bryce. I hope you're happy now on 103.7 Q Country as we wrap up our lunch hour. So when you call a business, oftentimes you're going to wait on hold. Unless, of course, you're lucky and you get the opportunity to have them call you back. I love when that happens. You leave your number and they call you back. It's so convenient. But if you have to wait on hold, this new poll found that 31% of us will only sit on hold for 5 minutes before we hang up. Yeah, that sounds about right. After 5 minutes, I'm pretty much done. 34% of people will wait 15 minutes and 22% will wait longer. The survey also found the most popular hold music is classical, but 15% of us would rather just sit in silence. How about you? How long will you wait on hold? Do you like the classical music that gets played? Let us know on Facebook or Twitter at 103.7 Q Country, or find me, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram at WX Brian D. Back to the office next with Jason Aldean, 103.7 Q Country. Cody myself, yeah. All right, second half of the workday. It's 103.7 Q Country. I'm Brian. All your favorites coming up for you while you get back to work. Brett Eldridge, Lady Antebellum, Blake Shelton, the next 10. Right now, Riley Green, I Wish Grandpa's Never Died on Q Country. Wish girls you- Do you have planned Labor Day weekend? I know it's quite a long way away, 9 months away. But Lady Antebellum bringing their Ocean 2020 tour to St. Joseph's Health Amphitheater at Lakeview in Syracuse, Labor Day weekend, Sunday, September 6th. What If I Never Get Over You on Q Country. Brett Eldridge on Q Country. It's Brian. Happy Monday. Hope the day's going well for you so far. And if you're looking forward to the weekend like I am, make sure you wake up early Saturday morning and catch Bobby Bones for the Country Top 30 Countdown. It's on every Saturday morning, 6 to 10 a.m. right here on 103.7 Q Country. He counts down the biggest 30 hits from Nashville every single week. And also, coming up tomorrow night, Bobby Bones will be on the show Running Wild with Bear Grylls on Nat Geo. He went out to Norway with Bear Grylls and filmed an episode of Running Wild with Bear Grylls. It airs tomorrow night on Nat Geo. Bobby Bones, and of course, catch him Saturday, Country Top 30, right here on 103.7 Q Country. Yeah, yeah. Today's Country, 103.7 Q Country, Monday afternoon. I'm Brian. Jay Gowen headed out on tour with Lady Antebellum this year, their Ocean 2020 tour, stopping in Syracuse Sunday, September 6th. Latest from Jay Gowen right now, it's Homing in Q Country. Did you watch the Jeopardy! Greatest of All Time tournament last week? Ken Jennings has won two games so far. James Holzhauer has won one. Brad, you have to win a game, but it returns to ABC tomorrow night at 8. Let's see if James can tie it up with Ken Jennings, or maybe Brad will win his first game. John Party now on Q Country. Same old Thomas Rhett, today's Country, 103.7 Q Country. Brian, Monday afternoon, thanks for having us on at the office. Apparently, doing a good deed works like a pain reliever. I'll tell you what this new study found after flooded Georgia Line. Blessings, it's new to Q. First time I met. New to Q from Brian and Tyler, flooded Georgia Line. Call Blessings on 103.7 Q Country. So yeah, this new study in China found doing something nice for someone works like a pain reliever. An MRI showed it lowers the amount of activity in a part of the brain that reacts to pain. And it even works with chronic conditions. So if you're under pain, you know, maybe you hurt yourself, maybe you had surgery, you know, whatever's causing you physical pain, do something nice for someone. Just perform a good deed. It'll work like a pain reliever. Forget Advil. Just do a good deed for someone. And apparently this study found that you will feel much less pain by doing that good deed. Just do something nice for someone, okay? It's good to do that anyway, whether you're in pain or not. Eli Young Band, coming up next, right here on 103.7 Q Country. Stick around. The workday just flying by on this Monday, already a little bit after 2. With 103.7 Q Country, I'm Brian. Thanks for taking us into the office with you today. Luke Combs, Even Though I'm Leaving, 103.7 Q Country. Daddy, I'm afraid. What was that thing? 103.7 Q Country, Maren Morris and her husband Ryan Hurd expecting their baby boy in March. So congrats to them, just a couple of months away from being parents. Maren now, The Bones, is on Q Country. Chris Stapleton with Millionaire on 103.7 Q Country. It's Brian. And if you're a fan of real country music, make sure you listen to 103.7 Q Country every Sunday morning. Join Chris Allinger from 6 to 10 a.m. every Sunday for Sunday in the Country. 4 hours of real country music. Great songs from the legends that built country music, along with weekly common thread themes. Plus, each week, Chris Allinger runs down the holidays, birthdays, number one songs, and country music milestones of the week. Spend Sunday in the Country, brought to you by Jim's Equipment Repair in Campbell. And of course, wake up with Chris Allinger every weekday morning from 6 to 10 for the Wake Up Q. It's 103.7 Q Country. We know you Zach Brown Band, they're returning to Syracuse for the 5th year in a row this year. We'll be at the St. Joseph's Health Amphitheater at Lakeview on May 31st. Tickets go on sale on Friday. Jordan Davis on Q Country right now. Slow Dance in the Parking Lot. Lights go down. Hey, make sure you're listening closely to Q Country all this week, because you have 2 chances a day to win tickets to go see Low Cash. Low Cash will be at Touch of Texas in Binghamton Saturday, January 25th. Win tickets with Chris Allinger in the morning and JB in the afternoon all this week. Old Dominion on right now. One man band. Been flying solo. Today's Country, 103.7 Q Country. Brian rolling through a Monday afternoon with new music from Trisha Yearwood. Every Girl in This Town, 103.7 Q Country. Every girl in this town. Trisha Yearwood, Every Girl in This Town, 103.7 Q Country. It's Brian. Don't go anywhere. JB coming up next at 3 for your ride home on this Monday afternoon. And he has tickets for you to win to go see Low Cash Saturday, January 25th, Touch of Texas in Binghamton. So stick around. JB getting you home next. And he has those Low Cash tickets for you. I'll catch you again tomorrow for Tuesday, the workday, 10 to 3, right here, 103.7 Q Country.
Cody Allen right here.